Hello, everybody, and welcome to the PEGX podcast. Today, we're talking about the essential training requirements for hazardous waste generators. My name is Michael Bryant. So who is it that exactly needs this essential training? If you're a large quantity hazardous waste generator, specialized training is required for all your hazardous waste personnel within 6 months of bringing them on board. The EPA defines hazardous waste personnel as anyone on your staff whose actions or inactions might result in noncompliance with applicable RCRA regulations. Put another way, it's anybody and everybody involved in selecting, marking, labeling, inspecting, moving, or otherwise handling your hazardous waste containers. Also note, all staff must be adequately trained who deal with your hazardous waste, either daily or incidentally, not just your emergency responders. That said, you might ask, would that somehow include Taylor, that nice young MBA who works upstairs in accounting? The answer might surprise you. Even if Taylor doesn't occasionally roll up his sleeves and help toss around a few barrels of spoiled yogurt, he still might be considered hazardous waste personnel if he's somehow involved in reading and applying federal or state hazardous waste regulations. Also bear in mind that such training is required of any outside contractors who might assist you with on-site hazardous waste management, or who might incidentally produce hazardous waste on your site, such as painters, repair companies, or renovators. Now, there are some exceptions for newbies. Mercifully, new hires can work under the direct supervision of a trained person for up to 6 months. Ditto for contractors. Their employees can assist with your hazmat management if directly supervised by a trained person, but only once, and only for a period less than 6 months. So what exactly does hazmat handling training involve? Your designated hazardous waste personnel must complete a program of classroom instruction, online training, and or in-service training that enables them to ensure compliance with RCRA regulations. Minimally, this includes training in emergency response procedures, applications of emergency equipment, and the operation of emergency systems, and they must complete RCRA refresher training annually to remain in compliance. However, whoever manages your entire hazardous waste program will likely need more training, and it's solely up to you to ensure that all your personnel are adequately trained to maintain compliance with RCRA regulations. The EPA provides a convenient laundry list of more specific required topics, which you can learn about at their website. They include procedures for using, inspecting, repairing, and replacing facility emergency monitoring equipment, key parameters for automatic waste feed cutoff systems, communications and/or alarm systems, response to fires, explosions, and releases of hazardous waste constituents, response to groundwater contamination incidents, shutdown of operations, evacuation procedures, implementation of facility contingency plans. So, who can provide this required training? Ironically enough, the EPA doesn't approve, certify, or otherwise accredit people or programs for providing the breadth of specialized training required by the agency. Suffice it to say, such training must be directed by a person trained in hazardous waste management procedures. To traverse such a minefield, make sure the trainers you hire can present documentable evidence of extensive experience with hazardous waste management, that their instructors are experienced at teaching, and that they are supported by a research staff who keep them abreast of EPA regulations, which tend to be bountiful and in dynamic supply. You also need to document your training efforts. As an LQG, you're required to maintain specific training records for those hazardous waste management personnel. The name, title, job description for each must be present with a detailed description of the amount and type of training he or she has received. A word about small quantity generators. Although there's no specific requirement for SQGs to have documented proof of individual training, common sense dictates the need for it. An inspector could ask for proof, and not being able to cough it up on demand isn't going to make him happy. Minimally, you should document dates and provide descriptions of hazmat training sessions for your SQG. Also, have sign-in sheets to record which of your employees have attended them. Don't get distracted. It can be dangerous and expensive. In all likelihood, hazardous waste management is not what you're in business to do. Instead, it's this nettlesome byproduct of your operations. It's overhead and a distraction from your core competencies for both you and your managers. Thus, designing and administrating a training program to keep your business EPA compliant and your employees physically safe is at least twice removed from what you actually get up in the morning to do. Under such circumstances, the likelihood skyrockets for committing unintended sins of omission, commission, or both. Why take the risk? Get expert help. Although they might be difficult to just Google, there are sources solely dedicated to providing comprehensive employee training for hazardous waste personnel, and many of them specialize in areas of hazardous waste management specific to particular industries and operations. For example, aviation fueling, site remediation, chemical and pharmaceutical compliance, food industry, and more. We know who and where they are. We can connect you with local and regional training sources that we've vetted and are proud to recommend. We can offer you literally decades of documentable experience with hazardous waste management. Our instructors are not just experienced practitioners of hazardous waste management, they're also superb teachers who are expert at imparting their knowledge and homogeneous audiences, owners, managers, and all levels of employees. They're supported by research staff who keep them abreast of EPA regulations, and they can help you establish an ongoing training program to keep you in state and federal compliance. Don't go it alone. Give us a call at 888-681-8923 or visit us on the web at hazardouswasteexperts.com. Thanks.